Welcome to Module 3. In this module, we will continue learning how to use ICT tools to teach entrepreneurship competences. According with the scholars, the best way of learning entrepreneurship is doing it. Because of that, we suggest to do in this module a journey through the entrepreneurship process to understand the main phases and areas of entrepreneurship, to dedicate Module 4 to learn which ICT tools can be used in each phase of the entrepreneurship journey and how to apply them. In fact, all the entrepreneurship competencies like knowledge, competencies, skills, and attitudes can be matched with the entrepreneurship process from the intention to build a project of entrepreneurship till the moment of implementation, this idea, this opportunity. Regarding the ICT tools, we have to be clear that in the learning process of entrepreneurship, there are a clear evolution in the ICT tools to be used. Currently, we assist to the development of different tools like games, virtual worlds, virtual laboratories, simulation. It's the learning 2.0 environment of learning processes, collaborative multimedia learning environments. And this will be evolved in the coming years to more sophisticated tools, ICT tools, to be used in this process, like data mining, learning analytics, neural network, machine learning, and so on. But as you can see, the most useful tools to be used in the entrepreneurship learning process are related to create real environment, virtual laboratories, simulation, just to try to do something similar to the real life of building a startup. In terms of methodological recommendations, to learn entrepreneurship, we have to promote heteroevaluation, peer evaluation, and autoevaluation. Also, it's important to create collaborative environments and promote the decision making of the students. We have to suggest moderate risk activities, tracking the process, and propose to do a clear exercise of planning between the student, and of course, use modeling as a methodological strategy, because that can help us to suggest and promote certain behaviors. Also, we have to promote communication and idea generation, and of course, we have to push for manage team learning. In fact, we can see that this methodological recommendation can be reflected in some ICT tools. You can see that some of these ideas can be reflected in gaming, virtual environments, simulations, collaborative environments, and communication tools. The first thing we have to do is clarify the startup concept, because an startup entrepreneurship project is not a traditional business. We have to do something different. In fact, a startup is an organization in search of a repeatable and scalable business model. We have to do something new and arrange in a different way. It's important to clarify that, to understand the different dynamics that the entrepreneurship process has in comparison to a traditional business. For the rest of the module, we will do a quick review of the different phases of the entrepreneurship journey. Starting from the business design, it's clear that we have to start understanding the environment where we want to create this new startup. Also, analyzing the business model, we have to do a clear and sustainable business model to succeed, and then evaluate it or proposition against the market, clients, and competition. Also, we have to develop the customer. We have to clearly make successful the startup by finding new customer and by developing an appropriate product. And also, we have to improve this process in a interactive manner and methodology. We will see in the rest of the videos of this module the different phases, just to understand what ICT tools can be used to learn the process. Thanks.